but it's very windy.
Bienvenidos a Barcelona. Your passports, por favor.
No problema. Nice grab.
Gracias. Thank you. Enjoy your stay.
I think I'll find a quiet spot to re-energize.
Don't you mean take a nap? Around here, they call it having a siesta.
Whatever you call it, I'm gonna go do it. I'll be just over there. See you later.
That's really cool. How do you guys climb like that?
Oh, it takes a lot of planning and a lot of practice. Hola, my name is Andreu, and this is my brother, Jose.
Hola.
Oh, hola. I'm Hogi. She's Lorna.
Hi.
And he is...
Shh, don't say it. I want to try to introduce myself in Spanish. Me llamo Bernie.
Well done, Bernie. That's good Spanish. But in Barcelona, we also speak another language called Catalan. So here, you could also say M. Dick Bernie.
M. Dick Bernie. Cool.
So, what do you call it when you guys stack yourselves all up like that?
We call it a castell.
Oh. You don't have to speak Spanish to know that means castle.
Sí, and we are castellers.
Jose goes in the middle. That's where strong guys with good balance stand. And the youngest, lightest castellers climb up to the very top.
And the biggest and strongest are at the bottom, of course.
And today, as part of the La Marse Festival, we are trying to make the tallest castell ever.
Wow! Can I try that? It looks amazing!
Well, you have to practice climbing first.
I'd show you how to climb, but right now, I have to get sashes for our new members.
The sashes support our backs. We also use them to climb up.
And they look pretty cool.
Can we come with you? We'd love to see Barcelona, even if it is from down on the ground.
That sounds great. I love showing off my city.
Just be quick, Andreu. We don't have much time.
Sí, sí. You can count on us. Som hi!
Ah, what's that music?
Well, Hogi, you'll soon find out. I have to get the sashes from that store, but you should join them.
Hola! You can call me the Dancing Duck. And you can call me the Dancing Dragonfly.
Me? Oh, you can just call me Hogi.
I've got them! Now we'll be able to break the record.
I'd love to be able to climb like you guys.
Here, let me teach you how to climb like a real castellar.
What should I do?
Step on my back. Don't forget to use the sash to help you up.
Hey, I did it!
Whoa, you guys did it! Wow, amazing!
Thank you, thank you!
Oh no! The wind! The sashes! Un, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco. One is missing!
Oh, there it goes! Follow that sash!
More help. You're right. I'll go wake Floaty. You chase that silly sash.
Look, here it comes.
I got it. I got it. Wow.
What is it, Bernie?
Die, die, die!
Whoa, they're part of the festival. These are gigantes, people in giant costumes.
No time for dancing, Mr. Giant.
I see the sash!
That is one stubborn sash!
How can we get up there to help him.
Señor Dragón, por favor. Hoagie, can you climb up here?
I can try. Mr. Giant, sir? How do I say thank you?
We say gracias.
Gracias. Aha! I got it! Go! Bad kitty!
Now I've got it!
Hang on, Bernie! Hey, did it just get really hot?
Oh, yeah. That's probably because of the dragon up ahead.
Oh, well, that explains it. Wait, did you say dragon?
Don't worry, it's a friendly dragon. It's part of the festival, just like that horse. Without all the sashes, we won't be able to break the record.
Hey, guys, I've got some good news and some bad news.
We could sure use some good news.
The good news is that Bernie has the sash.
Yay! Where is he?
That's the bad news. If I let go, the sash will fly off again.
Not even the best Castellars can climb that high.
Hoagie, I can fly, remember? I love the view, but my arms are getting a little tired. Excuse me, Mr. Pigeon. But my friend down there really needs that sash. This pigeon won't move!
Maybe it doesn't understand English. You could talk to it in Catalan.
I got a better idea. I'm going to talk to the pigeon in bird. I think he got the message.
At last! Thank you so much!
If we hurry, we can still make it!
Hop in, guys! Sorry, that's as close as I can get with all those people around.
How are we gonna get the sashes over to them?
I have an idea. How do you say, excuse me, in Catalan?
You say, perdoni.
Perdoni! Follow me!
Perdoni!
Perdoni! Perdoni! Perdoni!
Just in time! Castellars, get in position! If we climb as high as that mark, the record is ours!
That looks really hard, but kind of fun.
Yeah, really fun!
Andreu, it's your turn!
Go for it, Andreu!
Did we do it?
No, we are close, but not quite.
Oh, if only we could climb a few inches higher.
Aha! Hoagie, climb up here with me!
Are you kidding?
No, just remember what I taught you.
Okay, guys, hold on for one more.
I can do this.
You can do it, Hoagie!
Oh, boy.
Hoagie! 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 Hoagie!
It sounds like all of Barcelona's cheering you on! Come on! You can do it!
Whoa!
Phew! How are you feeling?
Well, just a bit nervous.
You are so close! You can make it!
You're right! I can make it! I did it!
Way to go, Hoagie! Did we break the record?
Way to go!
Thanks to you, we are now the best Castellars in the city!
What a fantastic day! Thanks for showing me the best view of Barcelona!
Hoagie goes to Amsterdam.
underpants. Bernie, you're not even wearing any pants, let alone underpants. Ah, why didn't anybody tell me? How long have I been like this?
since the day I met you?
Oh, yeah. Right. I don't wear pants. Never mind.
Anyway, where exactly are we going, Floaty?
Holland, Hoagie. Land of windmills, flower farms, and home to my favorite city in the world.
Would that be Amsterdam, Floaty?
It would be, Bernie.
Why do you like it so much, Floaty?
Oh, take a look and you'll see.
Wow! There are rivers all through it.
Those aren't rivers, Hoagie. They're canals. And we're going to land in one. So hold on, everybody.
Welcome to Amsterdam. Passport, please.
Passport? Sure. Here you go.
Enjoy your stay.
I could spend all day floating in the canals of Amsterdam.
Well, your name is Floaty. Ugh, canals are not for me. Know why? There's water in them.
Well, canals aren't the only way to see Amsterdam. There's plenty of streets you can take, too.
Bernie, Lorna, why don't we take the streets? Is that okay, Floaty?
Absolutely. If you need any help, you know where to find me. Floating, floating all over Amsterdam.
Okay, should we go this way or that way?
Whoops!
Oh, I'm so sorry.
That's okay, but are you okay? Are you lost?
Not lost exactly. We're just not sure which way to go.
Maybe I can help you decide where to go in Amsterdam. I live here. My name is Annika.
Hoagie!
Lorna! Bernie!
Hello! Thank you, Annika. We could use some help.
My pleasure. So, have you come to celebrate National Tulip Day?
You celebrate tulips?
We do, Hoagie. The tulips we grow make the whole world prettier.
Oh.
We're proud of that.
Oh. Huh? What are those funny shoes they're wearing?
They're called clogs, Lorna.
What noisy shoes! Clack, 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 clack.
Where is everyone going, Annika?
To the town center. On Tulip Day, you can get tulips for free. I was just on my way to get a special kind of tulip for my grandma. She's feeling a bit under the weather today.
Aw. Well, what are we waiting for, gang? Let's go! What's that delicious smell?
It's called Stroopwafel. Waffle caramel. Very yummy.
Where are the tulips?
A bit further on. This way.
Mmm. Aww.
Apple tart.
Wait. Aww.
Tompos. Puffer juice.
I need a puffer juice.
Uh-oh. Hoagie's tummy is doing the talking.
They're my favorites, too. Hard to resist pancakes with powdered sugar. Good?
Heavenly!
I'm glad you like it. So, are we ready to carry on to the tulips?
Mm-hmm. You betcha. Excuse me. So, do you see the kind of tulip you want, Annika?
Not here. But my uncle should have some. There he is!
Annika! Happy Tulip Day to you and your new friends!
Hoagie, Lorna, and Bernie, this is my uncle, Mr. Hans Flinkerwutzen.
Hello, Mr. Flinkerwutzen!
Whoa! Now I see why you celebrate today. What beautiful...
Gesundheit, Bernie.
Annika, I saved a bunch of princess tulips just for you. I remembered they were your favorites.
Oh, thank you so much, Uncle. But I'm not here for me. Grandma Flinkerwutzen is not feeling well. I would like a bunch of her favorites, the Queen of the Night tulip.
The Queen of the Night? Oh, nay, Anika, you're too late. I just gave away the last bunch. I was just about to head back to the farm.
I'm sorry, Anika. I guess my tummy made us late. If I'd known...
It's okay, Hoagie. I'm glad you've been enjoying yourself.
But I feel bad about it. Oh, wait! How far is your farm, Mr. Flinkerwutzen?
Oh, of course! I see what you're thinking, little frog. I have some Queen of the Night tulips back at the farm. You can ride in my truck.
Great! Let's go! Right, everybody?
I think that is a yes.
Welcome to my tulip farm.
Wow! Tulips do make the world pretty.
A windmill? Awesome!
Windmill, huh? What do you need to make wind for?
It is not for making wind, Lorna. This land was covered by the ocean once. Windmills pumped the water away so tulips could grow here.
So, where are the Queen of the Night tulips, Uncle?
Maybe you can find the dark purple tulips. They're out there somewhere.
No, not this one either.
Wait! Queen of the Night tulips! Uncle, I can't wait to get these back to Grandma.
Give her my love, Anika. So, everyone back in the truck.
Hey, Mr. Flinkerwutzen, what's with these bikes with the big basket?
Oh, my buckfits. Someone rides, someone pedals.
They look like a fun way to get around.
Oh, yes. I could come and pick them up at Grandma's with my truck later on.
Really? That sounds great. We'll get to see a bit of the countryside.
Okay, to get back, take this road to Stationsweg to Hofleitenswart.
Hoofs with the what? Oh, I got this. I'm great with directions. That way.
This is really cool. Whee! Huh? Right or left, Lorna?
Amsterdam's narrowest street.
Come on, guys, we can still catch up.
Where did he go?
There.
How did he get over there?
Come on. Oh, the flowers. Quick, let's run up and get them.
What's that sound?
That means the bridge is going up. Oh, no, the tulips were fallen and sank.
Amsterdam. Oh, my. Did someone up here lose some tulips?
Floaty!
You caught them. Oh, thank you.
Oh, you're certainly welcome. But can someone tell me what's going on?
Yeah. Floaty, meet Anika, our new friend from Amsterdam. We'll tell you the whole story on the way to Grandma's house, Floaty. We just need to get these tulips there before something else. Happens to them.
Oh, I see what you mean. Well, let's get a move on.
Special delivery. delivery, Grandma.
Annika, Queen of the Night Tulips? My favorite.
Annika said they'll make you feel better, Grandma Flinkerwutzen.
Oh, you dear child. It was just a sniffle. Nothing a spot of my special tea couldn't cure. But this is so kind of you. I hope it wasn't any trouble.
No, no trouble, Grandma.
No trouble at all.
Yeah, no trouble at
Hoagie goes to Bali.
Gonna catch you.
Flying looks like fun.
Well, I guess it is fun, Hoagie.
You know, Floaty, I'm the only one of us that can't fly.
There's something going on at the beach today that I think you're all really gonna like.
Wow! There's so many kites!
That's right! Kite flying is very popular in Bali. I have a kite in here somewhere. Will you get it?
Om Swastiastu, passport, please.
Om Stuetsu you. Of course.
Suksma, welcome to Bali.
Suksma! Wow! Even that guy can fly here. Hey, maybe I can fly here too. Hi! How you doing? Nice day for flying, huh? Huh? What's the matter, Lorna?
I had a kite when I was little. I called him Mr. Squid. I loved Mr. Squid. Until the string slipped from my wing. I chased him, but I lost him. I lost him!
Oh, then maybe you should fly this kite, Lorna.
Thanks, Floaty!
In fact, there's a big kite contest going on right now.
Great! I'll go sign us up.
Yay! This is fun!
I'm going down to the beach for a nice cold coconut drink.
Okay. Bye, Floaty!
Hey! Hey! Look at me, Floaty!
Oh, no! It's like Mr. Squid all over again! My kite! It's over the water! Ugh! Gross!
I'll get it!
Fault. Thank you for trying.
We're registered in the Kuta Kite Contest. Our kite needs to be in the air for the judges at 4 p.m.
Well, the only problem is...
the new Mr. Squid.
Maybe we can find a kite shop and get a new kite so Lorna can be in the contest.
Great idea! Let's go!
And I'm gonna find out about these so-called flying frogs.
Oh, hey! Wait for me!
Excuse me. Hi, I'm Hoagie. This is Lorna, and that's Bernie.
Hi, I'm Made.
Made, so we've had a little accident, and we need a new kite.
I don't want to talk about it.
Can you point us to a kite store?
Oh, there are many places to buy a kite, but all the kites in the shops have been sold out for the contest. And I should know, I'm from a family of kite makers.
Kite makers? Really?
Yes, it's a family tradition.
Would you make a kite for Lorna?
Sure, my cousin will help us. His shop is just up the beach. Hoagie, Lorna, Bernie, this is my cousin, Made.
Wait, you're both named Made?
In Bali, we're often named in the order we're born. The firstborn is Wayan, the second Made, the third is Noman, and the fourth is Ketut.
So, you're both the second born?
Exactly. So, they need a kite, so I thought we'd help them make one.
Well, that's great, but I sold all my kite gear for the contest. Look.
Huh? Oh, look, it's up there.
Oh, excellent eyes, Hoagie. The last package of my famous kite weights. I'll get a ladder.
It's okay, Made. I can fly up and get it.
Wait, Bernie. Frogs can fly in Bali, remember?
Ah! I did it! I did it!
It's okay, Hoagie. I'll get it.
Mr. Made, are flying frogs real?
Of course!
But I can't fly.
Well, we'll see. We still need lots of other parts, and the kite contest will be starting soon.
Can we go to Aunt Nimade's shop?
Great idea. It's in Ubud, so it's too far to walk. I'll go with you.
Wow! That's a lot of monkeys!
Hello, monkey!
Don't give him too much attention. He'll think you're going to feed him, and then he won't leave you alone.
Yay! Thanks for the tip.
Auntie Nimade's not here. Perhaps she's around the corner with her Uncle Wayan and his gamelan band.
What's a gamelan band?
Gamelan. It's the traditional music of Bali.
Listen.
Awesome! Fantastic!
Look at him. He's great.
Hoagie, Bernie, Lorna, this is my Aunt Nimade and my Uncle Wayan.
The music was great.
Ah, thank you, Hoagie. What brings you to Ubud?
We lost our kite.
I don't want to talk about it.
We are helping them build a kite, but we're all out of materials.
Oh, well, we can help you.
This is most of what you need. You still need bamboo and a crane's feather for good luck. It's a family tradition.
A crane's feather? Where on it? Where do you get crane's feathers?
Patulu.
Then Patulu, here we come!
I'm coming with you!
Wow!
They're always here, but at night, when the sun goes down, thousands of them come here.
Why do they do that?
No one knows.
Weird.
So, we need a feather from one of those guys up there, huh? Hey there! I was wondering if I could have one of your feathers. I really think I'm gonna do it this time. And up! I did it! I'm flying!
Well, I don't know about flying, but that was a pretty good hop.
Aw, it's no use. I don't know what I was thinking. I'm never gonna fly.
Thanks, Hoagie. Great plan.
This place has the best bamboo.
Where is it?
On that small island. But with the rain last night, there's so much mud. It'll be hard to get to it.
Well, if I could fly, I'd whiz right over and grab some. But...
No worries. I'll do it.
I wish I could fly, just like the flying frogs you have here in Bali, Big Made.
So, you have heard of the Balinese flying frogs, then?
Yes. I guess I hope frogs could really fly in Bali, because I want to fly with my friends.
Yes, I see. In Bali, in our stories, in our culture, flying frogs are special. They protect us, watch out for us.
Yeah, but I really wanted to fly.
Almost. Got it! Got it! Can't get out!
Bernie?
Bernie! Bernie's in trouble!
Can you hear that?
Bernie's in trouble!
Oh, it's just Lorna saying Bernie's in trouble. Bernie's in trouble?
He's stuck. I can't get to him because of the mud.
Mud is no problem for a frog. Coming your way, Bernie!
Thanks, Hoagie.
No problem.
This is all my fault. I'm the one who lost Mr. Squid again.
But if I could fly, I would have saved Mr. Squid, and none of this would have happened.
Right, and we would have missed this whole adventure. Oh.
And you're Hoagie. You're perfect like you are. I can fly, and I couldn't save Mr. Squid.
And I can fly, but if you weren't you, I'd still be stuck in the mud.
Oh, I guess that's true.
Come on, guys, it's getting late.
The kite competition!
Ha
you, but...
We hang these over the cradles of babies to protect them. You may not have wings, but to your friends, you're a flying frog all along. Because there's more than one way to fly.
More than one way to fly.
Are they being judged now?
I think so. I never even saw the kite when it was finished.
Hoagie, you won! Best flying frog!
Great! But you mean Lorna won.
No, Hoagie, you.
Hey, it's me! That's okay. I'm a flying frog who really does belong in the water.
Hoagie goes to Cape Town. Something else that'll impress you all. Today's destination, Cape Town.
Oh, really?
It's a city in South Africa. Oh, there's the harbor. And out to sea, you can go whale watching.
That's Table Mountain. Wow.
That would need a big tablecloth.
And if you listen out, you might hear them practicing for today's minstrel carnival. And here's the Victoria and Alfred waterfront.
Oh, Hoagie, take a look at these.
Whoa!
These are famous South Africans. This one is Nelson Mandela, who became president.
Hello and welcome. Passport, please.
Oh, you surprised me. Here you go.
Welcome to South Africa.
So what are we gonna see first? I really want to see the view from up there.
I want to go to the minstrel carnival Floaty talked about.
Well, it might not be happening today, but...
I want to see the penguins.
Penguins? They live in the cold, in Antarctica.
But it says here...
You might have better luck seeing other stuff from the ocean, Bernie, like whales. I want to go whale watching.
Penguins! Minstrel carnival!
Table Mountain!
Penguins!
Minstrel carnival! Table Mountain!
Whale watching!
Huh?
Hey, excuse me.
What is it?
I was trying to take a photo of that butterfly, but you scared it away.
What butterfly?
Exactly. It flew off again.
We're sorry. We're just so excited to be in Cape Town, we couldn't decide what to do first.
Was it a special butterfly?
Yeah, I was getting a picture for my mom. She's a scientist and writing a report on it. It's called a dark opal butterfly. They're becoming very rare and hard to find.
I feel bad that we spoiled your photo. Maybe we could help you take another one?
But we'll miss the carnival! And the penguins!
And the whale watching!
And climbing Table Mountain, I know! But we need to put this right!
You're right!
Yes.
Okay.
Wow, thank you! That would be great!
I'm Hoagie, and this is Bernie,
Hi.
Lorna, and Floaty.
I'm Dennis. Great to meet you. I'd love to show Cape Town to all of you afterwards to say thank you.
Great!
Brilliant! Thanks!
Ooh. Hey, this dark opal butterfly, it's not red with black spots, is it?
Yes, how did you know?
Because it's right there! After it!
Oh no, it's flying over water!
No problem, hop aboard, everyone!
Nope, nope! Those wings flap so fast! Missed it again! Whoa!
Sorry, it's just this butterfly is so fluttery.
It's landing on that rock!
That's great! Okay, nice and steady now, Floaty. Let me just line this up. All right. right, Mr. Butterfly, you ready for your close-up?
Wow!
Wow, it was a whale!
Wow!
Afraid I only got the whale.
It's a fantastic picture of it, though.
But where's the butterfly?
There it is! How did it get all the way over there so quickly? And are those the penguins?
Oh, don't be silly. Hold on now. I'm too big to follow the butterfly through the streets. I'll catch up with you later. I'm gonna go see if I can find that whale again.
See you later, Floaty. Come on, we mustn't let it get away. Just around this corner.
Wow, it's the Minstrel Carnival.
Cool, but it's too crowded to get through. The butterfly's getting away.
I've got an idea.
What's that?
I know we don't belong here.
Quick time! Hop, 2, 3, 4. Hop, 2, 3, 4.
The penguins?
Don't be silly. Come on, keep up.
Hold still, Barney.
Again.
It's a great photo of all of us, though.
It's not exactly my best side.
Hey, nice beach.
Thanks. It's called Boulder's Beach.
Boulder's Beach? That's where the penguins live.
Penguins? He thinks penguins live here.
Whoa! Penguins! Penguins everywhere!
Have we followed the butterfly to Antarctica?
These are African penguins. They prefer warmer weather than their Antarctic cousins. Come on! There's the butterfly!
Aw.
Sorry. It's all these feathers. Achoo! It is a very nice picture of a penguin, though. Hey, there's the butterfly.
This is the Kirstenbosch National Botanical Garden. This is where my mom works.
It says here that it has a spectacular tree canopy walkway. Wow! Sounds amazing. I wouldn't want to miss that.
Where did it go?
Don't say we've lost it after all that.
Oh, hi, Dennis. Who are your new friends?
Hi, Mom. This is Hoagie, Lorna, and Bernie.
Hi.
Hello.
We're trying to get a photo of the butterfly for you, but we've lost it again.
Who knew butterflies were so fluttery?
Never mind. Thank you for trying. You all look exhausted. Have some Drurwurst.
My favorite. It's a dried sausage.
Was it left out in the sun?
The drying process preserves it, so it keeps for a long time.
This one won't be kept for long. Whoa, it's getting windy.
I'm glad you came here. Lots of these plants are very special, as they only grow in this part of the world. They're called fine boss.
They certainly look fine to me.
It's a shame we didn't get a photo of the butterfly, but maybe we'll get to climb Table Mountain now.
Hey, is that the butterfly?
Where?
Right over there. Come on, it went this way.
The butterfly. Okay.
Are you sure you saw a butterfly, Lorna?
Well, I saw something flutter by, so...
Where? Huh? I see it again!
Where? I don't see it!
Me neither. Well, it's gone now. Come on, it went this way.
Phew! I wish it would flutter by in a more downward direction.
Shh. Look, it's landed on that leaf.
You got the photo!
Not quite.
Oh, no!
We've been chasing one of our drawers wrappers.
What? I'm sorry. It looked like a butterfly to me. It kept fluttering by.
Well, maybe it's not so bad. Look!
We did it! We climbed Table Mountain! Though, we never got a photo of the butterfly for you, Dennis.
I know. But hey, I've made some new friends instead.
You're right. Floaty got to see the whales.
And Lorna, you got to see the carnival. And Bernie...
Hoagie, stop!
Look!
Please don't interrupt me. This is important.
Hoagie, the butterfly is on your head.
Huh?
Hi, guys.
Floaty!
What? How are you getting on with finding that butterfly? Oh, sorry.
Come on, everyone. We can still do this. You're not getting away again. There it is.
No, there it is.
Uh-huh.
There it is.
Wow. We found our secret home.
There are loads. Maybe we were following more than one today. That would explain how it seemed to get from one place to another so fast.
Let's get this photo.
Wow, as well as a lovely photo, I can write in my report that the dark opal butterfly is not so rare after all. All thanks to you and your friends, Hoagie. Now, I expect you're hungry after all that climbing.
Drawers! Aha!
Thanks, Mom.
Just hold on to your wrappers. I've done quite enough chasing for one day. See more? Subscribe and like for more fun songs, stories, and facts.